Aloha Sunday School, it's Pastor Steve coming to you from the sunny paradise of Hawaii. I'm here visiting some friends and enjoying the beauty that is Hawaii. This week we hear a message of warning from the prophet Isaiah. But first, let's spend some time in worship together. Will you join me? Eyes closed, head bowed, gentlemen, hats off, let me pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this morning, for a chance to get together to worship and praise you and to learn from your word, the Bible. Father, we just ask that you would bless our time in your precious and holy name. Amen.
Thank you. Isaiah was a prophet to the kingdom of Judah. He had seen a vision of what would happen to the city of Jerusalem. Jerusalem was the capital of Judah. Isaiah told the people of Judah about his vision. He warned that God's judgment was coming to the people. God would punish the guilty. God's people had chosen to turn away from him and worship idols and false gods like their neighbors did. God always judges sin. Isaiah said that God's judgment was coming for the nations around Judah. Then he said that judgment was coming to Judah too. Judah's enemy, the Babylonians, would come into Jerusalem and take over the city. The people would try to get away, but they would be killed or captured. Isaiah told the people to repent. In his vision, Isaiah saw that instead of turning back to God, they ignored his warning. They danced in the streets and said, "Let's eat and drink, for tomorrow we die." Isaiah warned the people, saying, "This will all happen, just like God said." The people of Judah would be punished for their sin, but Isaiah also brought them a message of hope. God's people would be captured by the Babylonians, but one day they would be set free. Through Isaiah, God told his people to listen and obey. God would punish their sin because he wanted what was best for them. God would act for his glory and their good. "When you escape from Babylon," Isaiah said, "go, tell the good news of what God has done for you." God sent Isaiah to warn of his coming judgment. A greater day of judgment is coming when God will judge sin for a final time. Jesus came to die on the cross and rise again. Everyone who repents of sin and trusts in Jesus will be safe from God's judgment and have eternal life.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Kevin. It's time for questions from kids. Yori from Baton Rouge, Louisiana asks,
"Are all the bad things that happen in my life because of sin?"
Well, Yori, that's a challenging question. And the short answer is yes. All the bad things that happen in your life and in the life of everyone else in the world is a result of sin entering into the world. You see, God made a perfect, holy, right world, but Satan tempted Adam and Eve and they fell. And as a result of Adam and Eve being disobedient to God, sin entered into the world and has impacted or affected everyone since Adam and Eve. Now, sometimes we see in Scripture that God will punish people and bad things happen as a result of their sin. For example, David was both obedient at times in his life, but David was also disobedient at times in his life. And when David was disobedient, bad things happened because of his disobedience. Yet, we see in John chapter 9, when Jesus Christ is in conversation and he's about to heal a blind man, some people standing around say, "Hey, why is this man born blind? Did his parents sin? Is he in sin?" And Christ says, "No, it is not as a result of his sin. This man is blind so that I can heal him and so that the marvelous works of Christ may be displayed." So sometimes bad things happen because of direct things that we have done. And then sometimes bad things are happening as a result of things that happen to us. Now, bad things are bound to happen in your life. Maybe that bad thing is a scraped knee or a broken bone, or maybe worse than that, but bad things are bound to happen. What we need to ask ourselves is, how should you respond when bad things happen?
Let go. storms of this life. I won't turn back, I know you are near. I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. And if my God is with me, whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear?
Isaiah the prophet gave God's message to his people of Judah, but they didn't obey him. Instead, they worshipped false gods. Therefore, God had to punish them by allowing them to be enslaved by the Babylonians. But Isaiah did give them a message of hope as well, that one day they would be freed from slavery, just like we have been freed from slavery of sin through Jesus' death and resurrection. Well, it's time to go. I hope you have a great week, and remember that God loves you, and so do I. Bye-bye.